Okay, guys. In last video, I show you how to map our information signal, like let's say the arbiter signal into some of our a signal constellation diagram to a constellation point. So in last copy actually we discussed how to map this information signal into some constellation point in our signal space diagram, or simply constellation diagram. Actually in last video actually I show that we can have some set of constellation points in many different ways. Actually we can define many things. I'm not going to look in detail to those. So we can have a set of constellation points which are, each one is correspond to some linear combinations of our orthogonal signals or our basis signals, which can be written as, I say this is S1, S2, S3 and S4. In each SI, I can write as AR, A1I, Psi I, plus A2I, times Psi I, Psi 2, this is Psi 1 and Psi 2. So each one of these are linear combinations of our basis signals. So actually, we stop there and we measure what is the minimum energy set, signal set, and we determine, discuss several aspects of the minimum energy signals related to magnetics. Today, we going to give some special meaning to those constellation points. So far, we only map those signals to our constellation point, which can also can express it as a vector in elements, like in this case is AII and A2I, which are corresponds how much this signal contains of our basis signals psi 1 and psi 2. But the thing is, this is no meaning in relation to our goal to transmit some information from a receiver to a transmitter. We want to transmit some useful information from to transmitter to receiver. We want to carry some useful information by using these two basis signals. But alone, this constellation alone have no meaning in order to satisfy our requirement. So in order to satisfy our requirement, we assign each of these constellation points a symbol. We assign a symbol, right? Symbol. So let's say, what is a symbol, right? We assign some symbol. Let's say we assign, we can say, I will say always S1, S2 and S3, S3 and S4 are two for my symbols as well, because if I have used too many notation, it can be a bit complex. So I use some symbol. It means a symbol is nothing but a set of bits. It means it can contain one or many bits. In other case, in this case actually I have only two. So I have used only two bits to define those signals. It means I can give these symbols using two bits. I can assign four symbols to these four constellation points. It means I can assign 0, 0 here, 0, 1 here, 1, 1 here, and 1, 0 here. Actually, this encoding scheme is called a gray encoding scheme, which is actually, the meaning is the difference between each of these additions constellation points are only one bit. It is actually due to minimize the detection error. So actually in two bits we can assign their symbols. These are my symbols. Now our constellation diagram carries a mean. It means our receiver know, if it receives this constellation point, it should output this symbol. it should recognize, yeah, I recognize two zeros. And I receive two zeros and I put this. If it receive this constellation point, it identified it as it is 01 and return 01. It means we can successfully now transmit binary messages from TX to RX or transmitter to receiver by using these four signals and its symbols. And measure, and now it is not over. We want to measure certain parameters of these assigning of code blocks or constellation methods, which is known as modulations, in order to choose the most efficient modulation method to our requirement. In order to do that, we're going to define several stuff. The first thing is we define the minimum distance or d-min. D-min is nothing but the minimum distance between any two adjacent points in a constellation diagram. It means it is nothing to do with the constellation diagram. If you are given some constellation diagram like this, or it can be 3D as well, and you're given us certain points, it means we are given these points like this. Actually, this is not a typical constellation diagram, just as an illustration. If you know that I just get one point here, the minimum distance is this distance. The other points are too far away. So it means the minimum distance, it is the minimum distance between any two adjacent points in a constellation diagram. It is to do with the geometry. In exam, if you will ask to find the minimum distance of a constellation diagram, you do not have to worry about the digital communication. Just do it with simple geometry and draw the constellation diagram and choose and find what is the minimum distance between any two adjacent points. And it is to do with the geometrical case. Actually, the important thing is this minimum distance give us some measurement how much noise immunity or immunity to the channel variations this constellation diagram have. It means if you have high minimum distance, it means you have high noise immunity or high interference immunity, because you can afford high variations. It means you can our noise can move this constellation diagram this way or this way or this way or this way. If you have high minimum distance, you have more higher bound your variation, which can cause an error when it comes to detection. So it is the one parameter is the minimum distance between two of a constellation diagram. I know it is clear. It is just the minimum distance between any two adjacent points. The other thing is, when you consider a channel like this, it has a certain capacity. It means, imagine a water pipe. The water pipe has a certain capacity. You cannot use a small water pipe to give water to an entire village. You need a bigger one. It means that the water pipe has certain restrictions on water, carrying water through it. We cannot carry as much as water we want using a small pipe. In the same way, when discussing about communication channels, it can be a copper wire, fiber wire, or free space, we have a limit. That limit is called the capacity. It's a question of bits per second. In digital communication, we can write this as W times log to the power 2, 1 plus S in R. And this term is the available bandwidth. This is the signal to noise ratio. And we will discuss that in more detail. And this is actually the capacity. This is actually found by Shannon. And this is the actually upper limit of the information carry rate that the channel can have. Actually, we need this actually explaining bits per second. And by using this equation, we can find what is the maximum bit rate that this channel can carry. It means if we take RS as a bit rate of a practical channel, always this RS should be less than or equal to CS. The channel says that any rate below that the capacity, we can have a reliable communication link, provided that you have we have used the optimal modulation techniques and coding techniques adopted in our communication channel. Let's see what this SNR is. SNR means it's actually SNR, signal to noise ratio, is simply equal to signal power divided by noise power. Actually, this is usually measured in dB. And we can show that this is equal, I'm not going into derivations, bit rate, bit power into bit rate divided by noise spectral power density into the bandwidth. Actually, this is to AVGN noise, and to white Gaussian noise. It's actually N0 is the spectral density of the AVGN noise. And we can factorize this term. In this term, when we take this term, it is actually bit energy to the noise spectral density. We call this as bit energy to noise. Bit energy to noise. Or simply, we denote this as gamma B. And this term, RS over W, we call this as spectral efficiency. And we call it as gamma. And substituting this term into our equation to CS, we can show that CS is equal to W times log 2 to the power 1, log to the power 2 SNR. We can substitute this as W times log 2 1 plus gamma B and into gamma. And we can divide both sides by W and get CS divided by W into W. W goes out and log to the power 2, 1 plus gamma B, gamma. And we know this guy is greater than or equal RS. It means the both components should be greater than or equal to RS over W, or which is equal to gamma according to our derivations. So we can write this as gamma is greater than or equal to log 2 to the power gamma 1 plus gamma b into gamma. By solving this, we will end up, I'm not going to solve this, and we will end up gamma b should be greater than or equal 2 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Actually, this gives us a lower bound to our bit rate in terms of its spectral efficiency. In fact, we should satisfy this relation to have a successful digital communication link over a threatened link. If we plot gamma in terms of gamma B, we will get a curve like this. This is actually correspond to ln 2. And in this region, which gamma B is greater than 2 to the power gamma minus 1 divided by R, actually this curve is 2 to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. Greater than that, we can, it is actually gamma b, right? It is this coordinate. So actually this curve is correspond to that. With that case, we can have a reliable communication link. So this is this is actually the main derivation, which is a channel matrix, which is the thing that so how bit rate and power efficiency are related. Don't worry now, about these terms, because I am going to explain it again in the following cases. Just remember, we can measure, we have a thing called channel capacity, which is an upper bound to the data rate upper bound to our data rate over certain communication channel, and through that we can derive some relation between the bit rate and into the spectral efficiency. So this is the main one of the main two things we can look at in our communication channel. It means the power efficiency and the spectral efficiency. Let's see what does this actually mean. Actually, digital communication channels, we can compare any given two modulation schemes or many modulation scheme, two or many, we can compare actually exactly one with two, three or four modulation schemes at once if we want, with basically on three metrics. One metric is actually power efficiency. We can derive this as actually gamma B. It is actually the same thing we saw that earlier. Please do not confuse it with this gamma B. This is actually to do with bit energy to noise, and this thing is the power efficiency is not a thing like that. Actually, power efficiency is, in that case, we define as D mean squared divided by 4 epsilon B. Actually, this is actually a measure of how much energy we given is used to increase our D minimum, right? It is actually used how much our bit energy is used to separate these constellation points. It means, if we take some arbitrary constellation diagram, we can find the bit energy by finding the average energy of this constellation diagram. And this thing is mean how much our bit energy is contribute to increase this minimum distance. It means if this is power efficiency is big, it means most of our energy is used to separate these constellation points. It means we have high noise immunity. In simple words, it is how to remember it. Actually, power efficiency is a thing like we mean how much our energy is used effectively to have a reliable communication. It is one thing. The second thing is spectral efficiency. It's actually the power efficiency measure of how we use energy effectively to transmit our data. This is a spectral efficiency. It is defined as gamma is equal 2 to the power log 2 m divided by n. It means, in other words, this is a measure of how much bits I can transmit using my bandwidth. Actually, this is n is to number of dimensions. Or certainly how much orthogonal components we have. It means how much independent orthogonal signal components I use to transmit my signal. And how much if I use 3 dimensions, but I only transmit 8 constellation points, and some other person use 2 dimensions and transmit 16 constellation points, it is very much bandwidth efficient. It means he use less bandwidth and transmit more bits. Actually, spectral efficiency measure of how much we effectively use our spectrum to transmit our data. It means actually the thing is, if we use less bandwidth and transmit more data, we have high spectral efficiency. And go back to the power efficiency, if we use less power and we have high D minimum or high noise immunity, we have a lot of power efficiency. Because when in case we when we dealing with reliability, I told you before, D minimum is the measurement of reliability. It means we have high reliability using low power. It means we are very power efficient. So actually in practical sense, we desire high power efficiency and high spectral efficiency. Unfortunately, we can achieve this both at the same time. Actually, the actual happening thing is, when power efficiency will increases, spectral efficiency decreases. When spectral efficiency increases, power efficiency decreases. I'll show you why, and I actually demonstrate why this happens. The third parameter is probability of error. Actually, this is means how much reliability our channel is. It is very important in our communication system to be reliable. The thing is, we need to transmit data from a transmitter to a receiver. It means we transmit data from this place to this place, and we transmit data over this channel. The thing is, this receiver doesn't know what data we transmit at the transmitter. The receiver only makes its decision based on what it sees here. So the thing is, if our channel is very erroneous, our modulation scheme is it is not so good, we get high number of errors, which is not good. So thing is, that we defining is the probability of error. We can define it two ways. It means probability of bit errors or probability of symbol errors. Typically, symbol error is less than bit errors, because we know the thing is, a single bit error can cause typically is symbol error rate is less than probability of error of a single bit, because the thing is, as I previously mentioned, one symbol can contain multiple bits. If so, multiple bit errors can be correspond to one symbol error. So typically, actually, symbol error is greater than. Symbol error is greater than the bit error. The thing is, the multiple bit errors can cause one single symbol error. So it is typically the bit error is less than the symbol error. It's actually not too thing to remember. The error rate is how much probability we have to make an error when we make decision on the receiver. That is actually basically the things of measuring the effectiveness of the digital modulation schemes. And now we see what does this actually mean. Let's say we have a constellation diagram like this. To simplicity, I will take only one dimension. Like actually this example used by our sir, we have one A and minus A here. These are two constellation points. Imagine we have a finite band. It means actually we know that when we take complex signals like e to the power j omega t, 1t and e to the power j omega 2t, if omega 1t and omega 2 is different, we can show that these two signals are orthogonal. It means if we use different frequencies, we eventually end up with getting two orthogonal signals. So I use only one dimension, it means only one frequency to transmit my signal. It means I am restricted on bandwidth. if I want to increase the number of data points using one dimension, only one spectral diversity, and using a finite power, I cannot exceed power cap of a squared. I cannot transmit any signal which is having more power than a squared. So I'm stricken to those parameters. I have a power cap, and also I limit only one bandwidth just to show simplicity. So the thing is, if we want to do that, because actually in order we want to calculate the power efficiency, we want to keep other things constant. If we want to do that, the only thing we possibly do is to have constellation points here and there. Clearly, having constellation points there eventually decreases our distance between constellation points, which is previously equal to d. If we have two another constellation points here and here, like a divided by 2 minus a divided by 2, now our minimum distance would become to d divided by 4. If we have two more points, we become d divided by 2 more points divided by 8. So, and so on, and so on. Actually, the minimum distance reduces very rapidly in our modulation scheme. Actually, this is d over 3, right? We have this thing, this guy, and this guy. We have only 1, 2, 3. It's actually d over 3, right? And it is further reduced if we add more constellation points here and here and here and here. Right? It is more likely to our constellation diagram tends to be more compact, and our d min reduces. It means one slight deviation from our original constellation point can make a false decision at the receive. So it means if we have constraint on power and we increase the data rate, we have more our d min decreases. It means if we increase our data rate, power efficiency decreases. On the other way around, actually this is actually related to the orthogonal. Actually, this is related to ASK or amplitude shift keying. And if we use in the same way, if you want to avoid that, we have to. We want to use many dimensions. It means many frequencies. So if we want to maintain the same power efficiency, I have to use more dimensions. It means more bandwidth. It means if I want to increase the power efficiency, I have to decrease my spectral efficiency. And sometimes, it is also corresponding. If my power efficiency decreases, eventually my probability of error increases. If my power efficiency increases, if I have more d-mean, I can increase my probability error rate by the cost of the bandwidth. So, in the later part of our course, or in our next videos, actually this is our certain characteristics or certain metrics and certain introduction how to measure constellation diagram. And in our later class, the show shows how various modulation schemes such as PAM, QAM, and PSK, also actually we only consider about BPSK. And BPSK and also MPSK as well, and ASK, and that some various other modulations, the customized modulation schemes, and show us how to find d minimum and how to find spectral efficiency, power efficiency, and how to find spectral efficiency and how to find the probability of error. Probability of error, I simply say PE. It can be the error of symbols or a symbol error rate or bit error rate. The thing is, It is not difficult if you understand the concept of the constellation diagrams and the what does actually this power efficiency and medium distance and spectral efficiency means. You know that you only need to find these parameters. You need to memorize these equations. Sometimes it can be given. Sometimes you need to ask to prove these equations certain modulation schemes. So I'll show in this, I'll do it in next video by taking some questions and show how to find these parameters. But the thing is, if you given any constellation diagram, you only need to find these two things, the average bit energy and the minimum distance, in order to determine these parameters, because you can straightly determine how much of dimensions it use and how much constellation point it use. So the thing is, if you know the concept really well, you don't need to know what is the constellation previously. If you give any arbitrary constellation, actually this is what happens in, happened in previous exams. He gives us various constellations which are not standard constellations like PAM, QAM, or BPSK or something. They are totally new constellation diagrams, and we asked to find the d minimum, the and the power efficiency, spectral efficiency, various other stuffs, and the error rates and so on. In order to find the error rate, we need to know about some probabilistic distribution about the noise. Actually, it is going into the problem solving part. So I'm not going to derive them here. I do them in the questions because I don't need to do more theory stuff. So I just want to give the basic idea, and I show in next two videos how to apply these things in the exam level questions, and hopefully you can go it through. I want to make these things simple as possible. So I only include these two videos, which is in my previous copy, and this video, the only the basic concepts you need to understand about digital communications. This is actually is all about up to now. And other thing is the how digital regions can make and other stuffs I will discuss in the next video. The other theory part, how can we detect our signal with minimum error rate as possible from received constellation points. It is also other basic stuff. So I also cover that is in the basic stage, basic concepts. And after that video, I'll take some questions and show how to do the exam type questions in digital communication. So, and I highly appreciate your feedback on this video so I can make it better for you guys. And that's it for this video, and see you in